Now, in this video, let's talk about macroscopic and microscopic points of view. Now, this is not a very difficult topic to understand, first of all. Okay, the major difference lies, or I would say not the difference, but the similarity lies that we all know that each substance, let us say this is a substance, the when you look at it under a microscope, it is made up of a very, very large number of molecules. Okay, so these are the molecules which make up a particular substance. Okay, if I have to study about the properties of this particular substance, then I need to go about, or you can say I need to refer these two points of view. The first one is the macroscopic point of view. Now, what does macroscopic point of view mean? To understand the property of this particular substance, I would have to take a collection of these molecules as one. Okay, so I would have to combine all these molecules into a single molecule or into a single entity or a component. Okay, and I will study that whatever changes are occurring in this particular component, the same changes would then be assumed to take place for the entire substance. So when we consider a bulk, okay, a bulk of molecules in a particular substance, then it comes under the macroscopic, you can say, study. And macroscopic study is also sometimes known as classical thermodynamics. Okay, because we are assuming a major chunk, a major bulk of this substance to be one single entity, although there are these different molecules which are separate entity in themselves. Okay, now if you come to the microscopic point of view, again the assumption is same, that any substance is made up of a very large number of small particles, a very large number of very small molecules. Let me draw it again. Let me draw this diagram once again. So this is the substance. It is made up of these very small and large infinite number of particles. Now, each particle will have a different kind of motion. It has a different kind of velocity. It has different position at every time. Okay. So, in microscopic point of view, we need to consider each molecule as a separate entity. Means this molecule will have its own equations. This means every molecule will have its own set of equations. So one thing is there, that in microscopic points of view, we consider each and every molecule as a separate entity. In macroscopic point of view, we consider a collection of molecules or a bulk of molecules as a single component. Alright, but in this, we consider each and every molecule as an independent entity. This means this will have to be studied for its velocity. This will have to be studied for its position. Okay, this will have to be studied for its energy, for momentum. Okay, so you will have a number of equations to solve, and there will be infinite number of molecules in that particular substance. So this becomes very difficult for us to analyze. Okay, so what we do? We do all these calculations, we create all these equations, and then we basically measure, or you can say quantify or qualify the property by taking the average value. So microscopic points of view, or properties which are you can say defined by the help of microscopic points of view, are nothing but the average values of these infinite number of equations for each and every molecule in this particular substance. Alright, now this branch, that is the microscopic study of thermodynamics, this is called statistical thermodynamics. Okay, so now that we have defined that what is classical thermodynamics and what is statistical thermodynamics, or in other words, classical is also called macroscopic and statistical is also called microscopic. After this video, let's go on to a very important you can say podium in the subject of thermodynamics, and start discussing and start understanding about a thermodynamic property. So now let's go to the next video and talk about and define the thermodynamic properties.